Loudermilk, a half-hour scripted comedy that premieres on Tuesday, October 17th, right here on Audience, starring this man, Ron Livingston. Good to see you, brother.
Good to see you, Rich.
A pleasure having you here.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Where in Chicago did you grow up?
I grew up in Iowa. I grew up in Eastern Iowa.
So in Eastern Iowa.
Yeah, but we don't, you know, I didn't have a team in Eastern Iowa, so you got to pick between the Vikings, the Bears, the Chiefs. And then, like, some bandwagon guys were Broncos fans.
Well, the western part of the state might be more
western
Broncos
part
fans,
of the
right?
State, yeah. And the other thing is, you know, back in the day, we didn't, you know, have Sunday tickets, so you only got to watch whatever game happened to be on regionally.
Which was what, more often than not, in Eastern Iowa?
Back then, it was a lot of Vikings and Broncos. So, I remember, it's funny, I remember hating the Vikings because when the Vikings were winning, that meant it didn't even mean just that we're behind in the division. Now it meant I wasn't going to be able to see the game next week.
Interesting, because they would be always on because they were the good team.
Exactly. So that was hard.
But so you grew up winding up those choices.
Yeah. I was a Bears fan. I had an uncle who was a Bears fan. So
that's what it was.
And it was, you know, I mean, I was in high school in the early 80s. So, Walter Payton was there.
I mean, he's just sweetness.
It was a good time to, you know, hop on the wagon.
Yeah, Walter Payton will rope you in.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he did that to so many other people. And then the mid-80s is when it all went down with the Super Bowl shuffle.
Yeah.
And all that stuff with Jim McMahon and Walter Payton. And so it has stuck with you to this day?
It stuck. Well, then I lived in Chicago. Like, when I got out of school, I went to Chicago for 3 years to sort of start. And that solidified it.
That locked it up.
Yeah,
were you a Hawkeyes fan in Iowa?
I was a Hawkeyes fan. I lost touch with it once I moved out here. Again, it was before the satellite packages. It was like you'd get maybe one game a year.
One Hayden Fry game a year.
Yeah, one Hayden Fry game a year.
Chuck Long might sneak through.
Happel and Halverson. Those guys. Yeah, I remember those guys.
Those Big Ten guys will hit you.
Yeah.
That's when Chuck Long was beating Jim Harbaugh.
Best name for a quarterback ever, too, right?
Chuck Long.
Yeah,
it's better than Chuck dump off pass.
Yeah, right.
Chuck right? Screen
drop short. It'd be terrible.
Ron Livingston here on the Rich Eisen Show. So Bears now, are you still locked in on them?
I'm really excited, actually. After Monday night, you know,
that excited you?
Oh, you know what? Yes. Hey, man. You know, you got to remember, we've had a couple of rough years.
Yes.
I think you're aware of that. So, I don't know, seeing the new kid in there, actually getting to open the shrink wrap off of Mitchell, it felt like Christmas morning.
Yeah, with Mitchell Trubisky, part of it is the excitement to see somebody new and be able to just put all your hopes into that. And part of me is like anybody not named Jay Cutler, I think, right now have sufficed.
I'm with you, although I'm a Cutler supporter. You know, I'm an end user.
Mm-hmm.
So I played 1 year of football in seventh grade. I'm really glad I'm not making the front office decisions because I know nothing about what I'm talking about. So if you're
a fan, that's all
I'm a fan. And if you're out there wearing my team's uniform and giving it your all, which I do believe he did. I do believe
he
did.
But why do you feel the need to qualify?
Because I know he takes a lot of heat. I know he takes a lot of heat for that, but I do believe he gave it his all. You're my guy, and you're always going to be my guy unless you go to somebody in the division, in which case you're dead to me. So I'm
okay.
I'm both rooting for Jay and I'd love to see him do well.
But Mitchell Trubisky does excite you.
But this kid, I mean, it's to be just that young, and he was kind of an unknown. And I got to say, I was one of the guys, too, on draft day that was like, huh?
Right.
Right? I didn't.
You and John Fox, apparently.
Yeah. everybody, I guess.
Right.
So, it's to see kind of what we've actually got. In this case, I'm really excited about it.
So did you, Ron Livingston, again, Loudermilk, which we'll talk about in a second here on the Rich Eisen Show, Cubs, White Sox, did anything ever come out of you on that?
You know, my family's White Sox fans. So I would sort of ride along, but I was never a baseball kid. Baseball was very, very bad to me. So, you know, I didn't really play. I was terrible.
So in other words, there wasn't a baseball field made out of corn, out of a cornfield.
Not yet. No, that came later. No, it was just me standing out in right field, you know, dropping pop flies. So I don't like
right field.
Like overrunning all of them. They all fell behind my head.
So you found your right profession.
I never figured that out.
You found your right profession.
Yeah.
So let's talk about some of the things that you've done. Office Space to me is just one of the funniest movies I have ever seen.
Thank you, brother.
You are most welcome. What was that like making that movie, Ron?
You know what? It was great and it was terrifying at the same time.
Why was it terrifying?
That was the biggest job I'd ever had at that point. That was like a studio movie that I was the lead of. And I think I'd only done ever one, you know, little independent movie that I was the lead of.
Okay.
So this was a big, I was all of a sudden in a big pond. But I don't know, there was something about that. I just remember going to the audition and something clicked and I was like, oh, I'm gonna get this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? This is my thing.
Right.
You know?
And then Pieces of Flair hit and all of a sudden Jennifer Aniston is on the set.
It just took off, mm-hmm. you know? I think a lot of that was Comedy Central because nobody saw it in the theaters, that's for sure. But, you know, man, and it holds up. I really, you know, if it's on, it's hard to switch a channel.
Gary Cole. Oh. How many people have you ever had a boss like Gary Cole? Like, you know, did you get that memo? You know, did you see it? Did you ever have a boss like
You know, him? I don't know. I hope they're not really out there, although I suspect they probably are. Yeah. No, I never had one. And I had a lot of bosses because I was a temp secretary in Chicago for the, you know, that was my thing. And
that was your thing.
Yeah, that was my day gig. So I worked a lot of, you know, I worked a lot of office jobs.
And then you wind up in something like Band of Brothers with Spielberg, and Tom Hanks is part of that. How did you get hooked up in that?
Meg Lieberman, I gotta say, because at the time, like, I'd done comedy stuff, but I hadn't done drama stuff. I was just trying to get like a TV drama, and nobody wanted to give me that. Mm-hmm. You know, they were like, "Well, you're crazy."
Mm-hmm.
So, but Meg Lieberman, we'd done a movie together that she saw, and she was such a, you know, I was trying to get on From the Earth to the Moon, which was hers.
It's another Tom Hanks.
Yeah,
one,
another
which
Tom
is phenomenal.
Hanks. Phenomenal. You know, she was lovely. She brought me in 3 or 4 times. I never got anything.
A director or a casting director you're talking about?
Yeah. Okay. Yes, Meg Lieberman.
Okay.
Yeah,
and then so she put you in Band of Brothers. And
so she brought me in for Band of Brothers in it, and it just kind of clicked.
It's incredible.
Yeah.
And you were terrific in that as well.
Thank you.
Boardwalk Empire on top of it. So, I mean, Loudermilk now, where you're playing somebody who is a recovering alcoholic because you were, a music writer, correct?
Yeah.
Part of a
It's an old rock and roll critic, basically.
Rock and roll critic.
Yeah.
What's the basis of you being this character in this, what did you say, a drama comedy? It's kind of
I would call it a dark comedy.
A dark comedy.
But it's serial. It follows a storyline through the whole season and mm-hmm. it goes somewhere. It's not one of those reset comedies where you can play the episodes in any order and it still works.
Mm-hmm.
There was something to me about it. First of all, a comedy, a half hour comedy about recovery. Nobody's done that before. I had no idea what that was going to look like. So it scared the hell out of me a little bit. And mm-hmm. I figured out at this age that when something scares the hell out of me, that's the thing to go do, because that's what you get excited about. And the fact that we can be sort of uncensored, because we're on audience, we push the we're going to offend some people in places.
Well, I do that every day.
Yeah, well, there you
right
go.
Here.
But, you know,
mm-hmm.
but in a nice way, you know. So, I don't know. I just liked the idea of playing a guy who was like a miserable old cuss. Like somebody Walter Matthau would have played 30, 40 years ago, you know?
Like the buttermaker of recovery.
Yeah, exactly. You know, he was one of my guys, and I always wanted to do something that he might have done, and this felt as close as I was probably going to get to that.
That's great. No, now that you mentioned that you nailed it.
Yeah, well, that just means I ripped it all off, you know?
that's, hey, look, it's the way things go in this world. Loudermilk is Tuesday, October 17th, 10:30 p.m. Eastern and Pacific, right here on Audience Network. Come back anytime, Ron.
Thanks, please. Rich.
Certainly as Mitchell Trubisky starts breaking all of Jay Cutler's records for caring.
Yeah, for caring.
those are very high attained records, correct, Chris? Records for caring. Look those up.
They're all Jay Cutler's.
They're very good.
Yeah, I can't wait to see his cut block when they're running the Wildcat.
It was great.
Right?
Ron Livingston here on The Rich Eisen Show.
The Rich Eisen Show. Weekdays at noon Eastern on radio stations across the country and Audience.
If you like that, download our app. Please, just if it's a memory thing, just delete other apps. You don't need those apps. This app, The Rich Eisen Show app, you need that.